All right. This hand's just good. When the two-man queues had to wait a little bit, so I don't know what's going on. I think that like Soul Sisters. Okay, I have no idea how this matchup's gonna go. I mean, it seems like he's gonna have a bunch of creatures and we're gonna kill them, right? So things will probably be okay. He's not gonna be fast enough to really blitz us. I don't know whether they play discard or they splash black for like Tidehollow Sculler. If he has Martyr, he could gain a lot of life and then sacrifice. And then like a single Serra Ascendant could potentially nerf our entire offense. So I wanna make I'll wait as long as we can and make our army as big as possible. Ghost Quarter, okay, well we have enough basics that I don't care too much about this. Yeah, and I'm okay with Fulminator Maging that since we have the basics. It just kills his land pretty much. So, given the opportunity, we're definitely going to do that. Okay, we can cycle Jungle Weaver. And we're not in a huge rush to get him. I mean, he's gonna have a lot of life either way. Interesting, he's doing it now. Well, I guess he figures he'll get it back later. Interesting. Probably one of the best things you could do is Squadron Hawk. Honor the Pyre 3, Path to Exiles. Okay, this should be pretty easy to beat. Right? Seems that way. And a land, plus something he drew. Because the paths are not very good. And he just has no pressure. Oh, and he can't even use his Ghost Quarter because he tapped it, and we can just Fulminator Mage it. Or we could try to save two damage, but I think I'd rather just leave the basic in our deck. We're at 17 life, and he only has a 2/2, and as far as I can tell, basically nothing in hand. Red, black. Although, something to think about is. Well, actually. Saving two damage is actually a big deal, I think. And since we have the basics in our deck, three of them, haven't drawn any, I think it's fine waiting. There's another GQ. Okay, well. That's interesting. Well, we can blow this one up. That's fine, I was not planning on trading anyways. I want all of our stuff to go to the bin. Okay, so he has only two Path to Exiles in hand, and not really any pressure. But we do need to, like, a single Squadron Hawk could actually turn the game around pretty nicely for him. So the hope he's gonna kill his own Ghost Quarter. What's the point of that? Oh, I see, so that we can't use another Fulminator Mage on it. It's not a bad play. Playing an Arbor and we're just gonna chump with it, I'm thinking. Like, we could Living End, but he has two paths and he can just path our fatties. So we kinda need to wait to chain some more. And that gives him some time to draw into something, which is a little nerve-wracking, but I mean, like, aside from like a Squadron Hawk. Or a Spectral would put a lot of pressure on us too. Okay, that's not something I care about too much. Our deck's stocked full of these guys. We're bound to hit some at some point, and then we can get our game on. But until then, we just have to chill pretty much. Pale Recluse, sweet. So that's enough that it's like maybe we're like maybe okay with going for it pretty soon, and we have to go for it pretty soon because he's attacking for six a turn. So we don't have a ton of time. Six. Yeah, I just don't want to see a Squadron Hawk from over there, really. Spectral, okay. That's pretty annoying because it means that we're going to have to Outburst. So hopefully we draw into like another Cycler of some kind. Because he's going to be able to path, or maybe we'll just win off of Pale Recluses, who knows, right? Like, but he has so much life that like a Range Reveus or a Serra Ascendant or something could just like totally flip the game. Godless Shrine, okay. Drew a Verdant. So it's pretty awkward that we've gone through 16 cards. And we have like such a meager living end to show for it, but oh well, right? I mean, we can get another one later. And the issue is just that he has 39 life, right? So like, this is not the end for him by any means. Not by any means. And he can fulminate, he can double path, which is pretty good. I mean, we're still gonna have a sweet superior board position, but he has 39 life, and it doesn't take much to give him a sweet board position right back. But I mean, we've drawn 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 lands, so we only have 13 and 43 cards. We pulled 7 lands, rather. 4, 4, sure. Yeah, so I mean, just like that, we don't really have any attacks. Because these are getting pathed. And then we're actually behind on the board. But we can, like, chump for a while. And then, like, I don't know, Demonic Dread and stuff like that. I will board in Ley Lines here because the game's going to go long. We want Beast Within. We don't need Fulminator Mages. And I like Shriek Maws as well. So we can cut the Fulminators. And, like, three other cards. Okay, here's a dead shot. Happy to cycle this. Street Wraith. We're gonna Demonic Dread again at some point. I'm thinking I'm okay with attacking with these and seeing what happens. And then we're probably gonna go straight up do some chump walking. Fill our grave again and then do it again. You can get three threes and stuff. So who knows? Like, this game's gonna be tough, I think. Oh, really? Okay. Oh, I see. He's going to grow his guy. That's actually fine for us. Because we're just going to living end again, anyways. We need to make sure we don't accidentally draw it, though. That is something to think about. Okay, so we can chump with the dead shot. Swinging with stuff. I hope he paths the Weaver. Okay, Pride Mate. He's a big boy. Okay, he's not gonna do anything. We can swing in with the Weaver. He's got two paths. And then we slowly fill our graveyard. I'm gonna wait on this because we have plenty of mana. Might as well use this one. Overgrown. If we draw our last living end, things are gonna be awkward. Didn't. Okay, we can cycle, and then we can. Let's see what happens. I'm expecting that he's gonna path at some point. Just gonna take it, okay. Or is he gonna path? Okay, paths it. Good. This is all good stuff. This is what we wanna see happen from over there. And hopefully he attacks and we can chump with our team and cycle and then living end. Sierra Ascendant is fine. I'd like to see an attack from over there. It doesn't make a huge difference whether he does or he doesn't. So I'm thinking we should outburst so that we for sure hit living end. And then in response, we cycle our stuff. I don't really want to wait any longer because we're at 10 life, so we don't have a ton of life. He's going to be able to path something, and he's going to get 2 3-3s back, and he's going to gain 2 life. But, I mean, our board should be pretty good. Cast this. This is our last one. I mean, we have one in hand, which we can suspend, but. The timing on it will be awkward. So we can cycle twice and hopefully we hit more stuff. Ooh, and we did. We have forests left, so let's grab a forest. And then Stomping Ground can cycle anything. Yeah. Grab it, and then we're gonna cycle Street Wraith. So this, oh, this turned out awesome. This turn, he's gonna gain a ton of life. Yeah, this turned out awesome. He's gonna gain a ton of life, but his board is so bad, and we can swing for so much that I like our position quite a bit. It can crumble to like a any kind of a flyer. Any kind of a flyer can make our position crumble. And he has plenty of time because he has a lot of life. But we've got a huge army and we have good blockers. So it's gonna be an interesting game. We for sure want ley lines against him because we can expect kind of another one of these longer games. So he can path one of our blockers for sure. So we want like at least three blockers. Twisted Abomination. But I want to be as aggressive as possible. So I think we can swing with all of these. He can path our Abomination and we can double chump and go to three. And that's if he chooses to do that. That's fine by me. You know, we just want to like put the pressure on him because the ball is in our court, but he has lots of draws to get out of this between Spectral and Sarah's Ascendant and Hawk or whatever, you know, whatever flyers he plays. Okay, so that's going to be his game plan, is to try to kill us. And we are going to be dead to another top deck Path to Exile. So that is a risk that I just took by doing this. But I'm thinking time is of the absolute essence here. And I have no problem just chumping, swinging for a bunch. Like, I mean, he has to get pretty aggro if he wants to do that. 39. I mean, if he draws, like, even one land, he might just, like, be ruined. Yeah, probably paths our Abomination. Yeah, and then he can swing, and we have to double chump. And we'll be dead if he draws another path, which is a risk that I took here. But he's already played two. He can double chump, take three, and then the next turn, well, we'll see what happens. Like, if he has flyers or something like that, we're going to be in trouble. Okay. Interesting. So, he's keeping the martyr back. So, I think we should actually just kill a soul warden and take three here. Going to three is probably fine, and killing a soul warden seems pretty good. So I wonder what he drew that made him play in that way. Ravine. How many blockers do we want to hold back? If he had path, he would have killed us. So we only need to hold back one blocker. Because we're going to have a second blocker too. So it's going to give him the out of top decking the path again. Which is maybe a mistake, I don't know. But I don't want to give him even one more turn to draw a Spectral or something like that. Okay. He's at 17, so he's got one turn, basically. And we're at 3 life, so maybe he has path or something and we're going to die. But if he had path, we would have already died. So I feel pretty safe. I mean, something like a Spectral would kill us this turn. Soul Warden gives him another turn, probably. We have Ravine and we have Demonic Dread, so we can maybe kill him anyways. My assumption, okay, well, he may have a white card that he'll use for Martyr, so something to think about. So activate this, 4, 3. I think we can wait one more turn before, like, maybe going all in. Well, we'll see. Say he has two blockers because we dread. Two blockers, blocks the two biggest, and takes 7, 10... 18, am I doing this right? Okay, blocks this one, blocks this one. We dreaded one. Takes 3, 7, 10, 14, 18, 22, 25, and he can gain life too. If this backfires, I'll feel dumb, but I don't see how it can. Seems pretty safe. Like, he can even gain all that life. Can't block, okay. We could leave something back to block just in case, but I don't know. I mean, I can't imagine a card that he plays that could get him out of this. Okay, we'll see what happens. Seems like he's dead. He's at 19. That's not 29, yeah? So, say it's even a path to exile. Block, block, go up to 22, path 1. Take 6, 10. Okay, I mean, what if he has... Okay, we got him. Turn 11. Kind of a crazy game. Sideboarding, as I was saying, we want ley lines. We also want Shriek Maws. I don't like Fulminator Mage. I like the Beast Within because he's liable to have, like... Rest in Peace or something like that. I don't care for Ingot Chewer because it's pretty bad if he doesn't have a relic. And if he's white, he's more likely to have Rest in Peace. So we need to cut three more. I like all of the Reach guys. I like Abomination. We could cut, like... We could cut at least one, if not two of those. And we could cut Monstrous Carabid. The last cut is either going to be a Carabid or a Dread. I think six is probably plenty. That's maybe a big risk, but that's what we're going to try.